Hello everyone and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today in this tutorial we'll write a Python program to calculate the sum of numbers in the list without using built-in function. So input of this program is a list of numbers and the output is we need to find out the sum of numbers present in the list. For example, if I take list as 10, 20 and 30, I need to get the output as 60, the sum of the numbers 10 plus 20 plus 30, 60. And we need to do this without using the built-in function. In the previous tutorial, while calculating the average of the numbers in the list, to calculate the sum, we used sum built-in function. If you want to find out the sum of the numbers in any iterables, then you can use sum function. But here we need to write this program without using the built-in function. So for that, the first step is we need to take the input, here list of numbers. And the second step is we need to go through each element of the list and we need to add that elements. For example, if I take 10 and 20 and 30, in the program what I'll do is I'll take a variable, for example, sum list 1, and initially I'll take the value as 0. Next, I'll take the first element of list and I'll add that to this variable. So I'll take sum list 1 is equal to sum list 1 plus 10. So now 0 plus 10, the sum list 1 becomes 10. Now again, I'll take 20 and I'll add that to sum list 1. So initially sum list 1 contains 10. So now 10 plus 20, it will become 30. Now again, I'll get 30. I'll add that to sum list 1. Previously, sum list 1 was 30, now it will add 30, so it will become 60. In this way, we'll get the sum of the numbers in the list. So the second step is we need to iterate list 1 and we need to add the elements. And last step is you need to print the result, sum. Alright, so to do this, first let's take the input. You can take the input from the user or you can take list directly. So first I'll take list directly. In the Python file, I'll take a list and here I'll take list name as list 1 and I'll take few elements like 10, 20, 30. After taking the input, we need to go through each element and we need to add that. So to do this, first I'll take a variable called sum list 1 and initially I'll take its value as 0. This is the variable where we'll store the final result. Initially it is 0. Next, we need to go through each element, right? We need to iterate through list 1. So for that, I'll use a loop and here I'll take for I in list 1. To get the list element individually, we need to use loop. Now, I initially becomes 10. Next, in the second iteration, it will become 20. And in the third iteration, it will become 30. Now, here what I need to do is, I need to take sum list 1 plus I. So here, initially, I'll take sum list 1 as 0. Then I'll take for I in list 1. So initially I value will be 10. Now here sum list 1 value is 0 and I value is 10. So 0 plus 10, so it will become 10. Now again control will go here in the loop and I value becomes 20. Previously sum list 1 was 10, now plus 20, so it will become 30. So that will be stored in this. Now again control will go to the for loop and I value become 30. Sum list 1 was 30 previously, 30 plus 30, it will become 60 and that result will be stored in this. So in this way, it will add the individual element of the list. Next, after doing this, we need to print the result. So outside the for loop, here you need to print. I'll print a message sum of list is and here I'll write the variable name sum list 1 which contains the output. Right, so now we are done with the program. The first step was this, we need to take the input and the second step is we need to go through each element of the list and we need to add that. So for that we are using a variable sum list 1 and we'll initialize that to 0. Next, using the loop, we'll go through each element and we'll add that to sum list 1. Next, we'll print the result. You can clearly see the three steps, right? So let's execute this and we'll get the result as 60. Because we took elements as 10, 20, 30, so we'll get the result as 60. You can take the list as user input also. So for that, first you need to take how many elements you want in the list. So int input, I already explained you about this in a video, so I'll give you the link of that video in the description box. You can go and check that. You can print a suitable message here, how many elements you want in the list. You need to take an empty list, then using loop, you need to execute this loop n times, so take range n, and here you need to take list1 dot append int input. We need numbers, right? So integer numbers, so I'm taking integer input. So in this way you can take the user input. So let's execute this and we'll see how it works. How many numbers you want in the list? Let's take 5 numbers. Then you need to enter 5 numbers here, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So sum is 15. 1 plus 2 is 3, 3 plus 3 is 6, 6 plus 4 is 10, 10 plus 5 is 15. So sum is 15. So we are getting the proper output, right? So if you want to find out the sum of the numbers in the list without using the built-in function, then first you need to take the input, and in the next step, you need to go through the each element of the given list and you need to add that numbers and you need to print the result. Alright, so that's it for now guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will meet you in next class. Till then, take care.